Today, I want to share with you details of a free luminosity masking panel that's one of the best you'll find. In fact, it's so good, I used it extensively in my latest luminosity masking course. The panel is called Interactive Luminosity Masks, and it's very simple to use, which makes it so powerful. You've got an option first off to create a luminosity mask or a saturation mask. We're going to look at a luminosity mask to start with, and I'll use this image that you see on screen to show you how you can make further adjustments using luminosity masks. So we'll start with a luminosity mask, and what I want to do is select the sky here so that I can actually reduce its brightness very slightly. To do that, I can use the highlights mask. So the highlights target the highlights in the image. You've got the midtone masks that target midtones and shadow masks that target the darkest areas. Now there's something else as well called a zone mask, and we'll come to that later, but we'll go with the highlights mask to start with. Now as soon as I select that, what we've got is this curve here, and this is what helps us control the selection. Over in the main window, you can see the highlights in the image are shown as white, and the darkest areas are shown as black. The areas between the two are the grey areas, and they're transitions that help you make blending easier. Now you can control this curve even further to actually select the areas you want, and you can do that with these buttons here. Personally though, I prefer to grab and drag the slider here. So if I move this over to the right, what you can see is that we're selecting more of the shadow areas in the highlights. And that's actually shown with this curve not being quite as steep. If I move it over to the right, we focus our attention onto the brightest areas in the image. Now I'm going to set that to around here, the mid area. And what that will let me do is it will target these areas of the sky that you see white, and it will allow me to just darken them that little bit. And I'll show you how I'll do that in a moment. First though, we have to decide what is it that we want to create. We can use the mask to create a selection or channel, or we can pick one of three adjustments that are commonly used with luminosity masks, and those are the curves, levels, or the hue and saturation layer. Now I'm going to create a channel out of this because I want to save it in case I need to go back to it and use it again in the future. I click the channels option, and now I can name my new channel. For this, I'm going to call it Bright Sky. And that's just a reminder to me that it selects the bright areas in the sky. So that's my channel actually created. If I go over to the channels window, you can see the channel here, Bright Sky, that I've just created. And if I click it, you can see what it is. I'm now going to add a curves adjustment. And I'll use that now to darken the image. Now as I've done that, you can see the saturation increase as well as reducing the brightest areas. The problem is, it's made that change across the entire image, and I don't really want that. So what I'm going to do is select my mask here, and I'm going to invert it to hide the effect. I can now go back to the channel that I created called Bright Sky, and I can load that here as a selection. Now once I've got that as a selection, I can actually pick my mask again, and I can, with a brush tool, paint over the sky. Now I'm just going to use a large brush tool here so I don't have to do many brush strokes. And I'm just painting in the area of the sky that I want to actually affect. Now it's taking a little bit of time to update because I'm using such a wide brush, and I'm painting through the selection that we created. Now what the selection's doing is, it's restricting my brush stroke, so only painting into the highlights. So let's say that's enough selection for the sky. I'm just going to reduce the brush stroke size, and I'm now going to paint just onto the foreground here. Now I'll just get rid of my selection, and you can see the difference if I turn the layer off. If I look at the mask that I've created, I'll hold down Alt on my keyboard and click the mask. You can see that I've painted into the areas where I want the effect to be seen. And because I've been painting through the selection that we created using the Luminosity Mask tool, it looks a little bit like the channel that we created before. If the effect's a little bit too strong, you can always reduce the opacity on the layer. Let's now look at actually lightening the rocks, which are a little bit too dark in this example. And again, I'll use the Interactive Luminosity Mask tool. So I come up to my tool, I'll select the Luminosity Masks, and this time I'm going to select the Shadows. So immediately you can see that I'm now targeting the darkest areas in my image. And again, I can control it using this option here to feather the effect. Now I don't want to affect just the darkest areas, so I won't keep the feathering low. I'll actually move the feathering up so that we've got a reasonable area. And I'll use the paintbrush technique that I used before again. So again, I'm just going to save this now as a channel, and I'll call this Dark Rocks. I'll now add my adjustment layer as I did before, so we'll use the curves again. And this time I'm going to use the curve to lighten the rocks. Again, it's affecting the entire image, so I'll select the mask, I'll invert it to hide the effect. I'll go back to pick my dark rock channel. I'll load that as a selection. Back to the layers window, select the mask that's all black at the moment, and now I'm going to paint in the area of the rocks using the brush tool with white paint. As I'm painting, the effect that we created with the adjustment is actually starting to be seen in the rocks. Now I'm not painting a big heavy adjustment here. I want to keep this looking quite natural. I'll clear the selection so that you can see what I'm doing. You can, of course, hide the selection while you're painting, but at the moment I'm just trying to demonstrate some of the techniques. And now my lightening of the rocks has been completed in just the area where the rocks are very dark. And you could, of course, go on and target areas like the lighthouse or the sun and really make a difference on this image. If I look at the mask I've created, there you can see it. And you can target things much more precisely than I'm doing here. If you want to make the effect stronger, you can do. But if you make it too strong, be careful, because it can start to look unnatural. If you think it's too strong, just reduce your opacity slightly. Let's now look at using a saturation mask, and we'll target the sky and really go to town and boost the saturation in those areas. Again, the Interactive Luminosity Mask tool, I'm going to create a saturation mask this time. And to show you how it works, I'll use the zone mask. Now it's very, very similar to using the other masking tools such as highlights, midtones and shadows, but we can pick zones of brightness or zones of saturation in the image, and we can do that using this slider. So as I move the slider left and right, what you can see is this curve moves left and right, and you can use these feather controls here to determine how precise the selection is that you're going to make. Now all you need to remember is the light areas are where the selection is, the dark areas are where the selection's being hidden. So what I can do is move this adjustment now to target the areas of the sky that I want to target and enhance the saturation with. Once I'm happy, I'll save that as a channel again, and we'll call this Boost Saturation. I'll now add a hue and saturation adjustment layer, and I will target the yellows in the sky, and I'll use the picker tool just to pick out the areas that I'm really interested in. And you can see the selection down here in the tool. I can now boost the saturation quite strongly in those areas. I'll again invert my mask to hide the effect. I'll go back to the channels window, select the boost saturation channel and load it as a selection. And again, I'll paint in the areas that I want to enhance the saturation effect. So I'll use a big paintbrush and I'll just paint over the sky. And I'll also paint over the water in the foreground here. And a little bit here as well. If I remove the selection, and I'll show you the mask, you can see the areas I've painted in to enhance the saturation. If I turn that off, you can see the subtle difference. And of course, you can enhance the adjustment still further if you wanted to. So if I select all three of those layers now, I can place them into a folder and turn that off and on so you can see the adjustment difference. So Interactive Luminosity Masking Panel, it's really useful and it's free, which is the great thing about it. If you're interested, I'll put the link in the information below, as well as the link to the Luminosity Masking course that I use this in. One other thing that I would like to draw your attention to though, is this button here, Buy Me a Cookie. The author of this panel hasn't asked for any money in payment of this. If you like it, you can use that button to donate a small sum to him. Now, I have nothing at all to do with this panel. I just think it's a really great tool. I'm very pleased that the author created it. I hope you found this useful. I'm Robin Whalley. You've been watching Lenscraft. I'll see you next time for another video.